In this video, you will watch what is FOMAX, what are its advantages, system description, component of FOMAX system, location of those components, software installed in FOMAX computer, how to access FOMAX system for maintenance, and finally uploading FOMAX software through PMAT 2000. So watch the video till end and do subscribe our channel and press bell icon for notification.
Quick little review for the beginners. What is FOMAX? It is abbreviation for Flight Operation and Maintenance Exchanger, designed by Rockwell Collins System for Airbus. It is onboard connectivity solution which enable airlines to collect aircraft maintenance as well as performance data onboard the aircraft and automatically transmit it to the ground-based operations center at a higher speed than previously possible and in real time. It also provides secure server router which connect flight crew electronic flight bag EFB to aircraft system over the secure IP internet protocol via Wi-Fi. It gives us advantages like real-time info, quick turnaround time, onboard performance, increased reliability, and digital maintenance record. The system contains one FOMAX LRU computer which is connected to all other aircraft systems and receives the data through ARINC 717 buses. In flight, it transmits the data via satellite communication and is connected to aircraft communication manager. When aircraft is on ground, it transmits the data by cellular gatelink network. For transmission, there are two antennas located inside the cabin. One is specifically for Airbus cellular network and other is for operator cellular network. On face of FOMAX computer, there are 8 SIM card slots, 4 for Airbus SIM card and 4 for airline SIM card. For flight crew electronic flight bag for accessing the data, there is one Wi-Fi antenna which is located inside the cockpit on the left side behind the captain's seat. FOMAX computer is installed with 4 different software: core software for operating system, configuration data to adapt the Airbus setting, airline configuration setting for customization of data required, and Airbus configuration setting for customization of data required. All software is field loadable. If we are uploading number 1, that is core software, then all other 3 software is automatically deleted and has to be re-uploaded. But if we are uploading only 2 or 3 or 4 software, then it can be done individually without affecting other softwares. In this video, we will be doing uploading of airline configuration setting through PMAT 2000. Locations for the computer and uploading receptacle. It is available in 80 view. You can go through the access door. The computer is installed on the first rack 81 view. The fin number is 64 Tango Alpha and installed on 81 view. Below the 80 view, there is 2 receptacle for FOMAX system. One is for data loading through which we will connect PMAT for uploading the software, and other is for maintenance through which we will connect the external laptop and we will start the LMF application, local maintenance function, by which we can access FOMAX computer for maintenance like status of system, troubleshooting, error log and identification of software part numbers. This is provided because we cannot access the computer from MCDU. Data loader receptacle is compatible with PMAT 2000 uploader, and for maintenance, RJ45 receptacle has been provided for connecting it to the laptop via LAN cable.
Before we do any type of uploading, we have to check current software part number. This will be done by local maintenance function. On 1-to-1 view, make sure Juliet 1CB for FOMAX computer is pushed in.
Next, we will connect our laptop to the receptacle for the FOMAX maintenance receptacle with the help of LAN cable. The laptop is pre-installed with LMF application.
After connection is done, we will start local maintenance function application on our laptop. It will take few seconds for proper response.
On left hand side, you can find all the status and the menu option. On the top, you can find submenu for each main options. For checking the part number for the software, we will click on FOMAX internal and then we will go on configuration. Here is the detailed configuration of our FOMAX system on this aircraft. The top you can find hardware fin number, that is 64 Tango Alpha, part number of the computer and serial number. Then comes software fin number and part number. Core software, configuration, airline customization and Airbus customization. Right now we are doing airline customization, so we will note down the part number for the current software.
This is the connection cable for our PDL PMAT 2000. This connector is labeled as computer, so this will go to the aircraft side, the data loading receptacle. The other side is marked as a PMAT 2000. This will go to our portable data loader. So our connecting cable will be connected on this J1 receptacle and the USB with the software loaded will be connected over here in USB 1 or USB 2.
There are two methods of uploading. First, using a flash drive directly and using PMAT as a medium. In this way, we always need flash drive and PMAT together each time we do uploading. Second method is using PMAT with preloaded software. In this method, we upload our software from flash drive to PMAT first, and then PMAT is used to upload it to the aircraft without the need of flash drive any number of time. This is the main menu screen of our PMAT 2000. We will click on ARRING 615 Alpha Data Loader. Number 1 username, we will put our operator code. Number 2 tail number, we will put registration of the aircraft we are uploading. And number 3 connection type, we will select FOMAX. We are writing our company name, and then we will select tail number, registration number, and on third we will select FOMAX. After selecting, we will click on number 4, continue. So this is the another screen, select an operation. We will select upload option. Now it is finding a target name, so it may take little while. Once it is displayed, make sure that the box is in green color. Select it and then click on continue. Here they are asking us the source. So as we are doing with the flash drive, we will select removable media. Once you click on removable media, it will show you the pen drive, D drive removable. We'll select it. In filter, we will select nothing. It should be any attribute. In model number, any model, and in tail number, it is already pre-selected as we typed before. Parts to upload, it is showing the software which is available in this pen drive. So make sure that the part number is correct with your task card or work order, and select it and then click on continue. Now it is validating the signature for the software. As per AMM, even if no signature is present, we can still continue. So no signature present, we'll select the software part number and then we'll click on OK. Tick the load serial checkbox and click on continue upload. Now PMAT is uploading our software in FOMAX computer. The status you can check, it is connecting to the target and then it will come in progress. As it was airline configuration setting, it will take very little time to be completed. So it is done, the status is completed and progress bar should be in green color. It should not be in red, otherwise it is failed. We will click on close and then we will click on go back. Software which is uploaded should be rechecked by local maintenance function. So I will show you the video after second method of uploading. Now we will check second method of uploading. We will transfer our software from pen drive to PMAT first. So pen drive connected, we will select load star option. Here you make sure that you are in library tab and you have to click on install software. So here they are asking get loads from. So we have to click on removable media and then click on next. Number 1, select the flash drive. Number 2, scan. Number 3, it will show available softwares. So check the part number of the software and click on number 4, import. It will copy the software from pen drive to our PMAT. Now here we have to click on this new load directory and we'll select the software and then click on next. Now here it is asking you all different kind of options. Confirm the software part number and click on the checkbox. Model number A320 checkbox. System LRU, we'll select it later on. If software is common for all 320, we'll select all the checkbox, but the software is for one particular aircraft registration, then we select only that registration. Once all the selection is made, we'll click on next option. It will start installing the software. So now software is being installed. Installation complete, we'll click on OK and then we'll click on go back. Now we will go in library management to assign the LRU. So from the left side, make sure you are selecting the correct part number for the software which we are installing. So I'll just select it and then in system LRU, search for FOMAX computer. Tick the checkbox of FOMAX computer. So here is the FOMAX. In 665 option, you don't need to select anything as it is concerned with Boeing 777 uploading. So we'll select FOMAX and then we'll click on update. Then we'll click OK and then go back. We'll log off from the Loadstar and then we'll proceed with the uploading. So it'll follow the same step as what we did before. Only one step is different, which I'll show you. We'll select username, tail number, connection type FOMAX, and then click on continue.
Then we'll select upload and wait for Formax computer to be shown in green bar. So we'll select Formax and then click on continue. So this is only the difference. In source it is selected internal and you can already see the software part number already shown. So we'll click on that software part number and then we'll click on continue. Rest all step is same as we followed before. After the software is uploaded, we will check the part number of the software with local maintenance function. We will confirm successful uploading of our software by checking the current part number through local maintenance function. So here you can see the part number is 1124 ECO which we uploaded and the old one is 00812 ECO. Hope you guys learned something. Do share the video and subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching. Take care.